So what we're creating at BYU are developable mechanisms that make it possible to make complex machines that integrate onto surfaces to be very compact, but now can deploy and do complex things.
A developable mechanism can reside in a curved surface. So it's kind of hidden in there. And then when I actuate, boom, it comes out of the surface. So one example might be things that reside on Iron Man's suit. For instance, on his arm, there's some kind of covering there. That's a developable surface. And if there's a mechanism that comes out of that, does something cool, comes back in, that's a developable mechanism.
So there are a lot of industries that this can apply to. One of which is surgical equipment. If this was to scale, it'd be a small, minimally invasive surgical device. And as it goes in, you have two different components that will unfold off of it, one of which could be a camera or a light, which still leaves this center tube hollow for a different device, such as these forceps, to now come in and do the operation.
This technology shows the most promise in the medical industry and the space industry. So for in the space industry, you want it to be compact for launch, and then once it gets into space, it can deploy. This may be a rocket or a missile and have this fairly complex mechanism that just morphs and transforms off of that surface. Here's a wheel that's rolling on, a Mars rover. We hit some obstacle, we deploy that, becomes a crawling mechanism that can crawl over those obstacles. We're also beginning to look at things like deployable drones.
So I want to have the drone be nice and compact when I carry it around. So what's fun here is it's deployed, right? Then it can go back into the surface.
We're doing work in origami-based engineering. And as part of that, we moved into curved folds. The mathematics revealed we can implant machines on there that will have these complex functions and morph out of those surfaces.
We usually design the mechanism independent of its home. So the idea of using a curved surface as the kind of home for a mechanism, that's revolutionary because we don't tend to think about mechanisms in this way.
Suddenly we could do really complex things that no one's ever been able to do before.